से बाय टू Surbhi, बिकॉज ये वीडियो भी बहुत ही घमासान मोड़ लेने वाला है. आई एम गोइंग टू डू कट टू समथिंग दैट आई शॉट अ फ्यू डेज अगो. लेट्स गो बैक अ फ्यू डेज, वॉच दैट वीडियो, कम बैक टू टुडे. Today's video, I wanted to continue the conversation that I started 2 weeks ago when I posted a video titled The Most Affordable MS in Computer Science. I know I was wearing the same t-shirt that day as well, but as I said in that video, branding matters. So that video has been gathering some views every day consistently. And when that happens, what do? You basically make more videos on the same topic. So I received a few questions on my Instagram DMs and also in the comment section on the video that I posted. And I wanted to share some resources that are available to you related to the OMS-CS program at Georgia Tech. All right, let's talk about the very first scenario. Let's say you are a third year, fourth year student who's pursuing engineering or any other field for that matter, and you are not in the US and you are deciding for higher education and you chose computer science to be your option. If you are in that zone where you are planning for higher education and want something that is affordable, you can opt for OMS-CS. I have their website open here and we will go through very few things on what you need to do in order to start the process. I already mentioned in the first video I posted on this topic that the application process is very similar to what it would be when you were to attend a college physically. You need the exact same documents except for GRE. So if you come to this page, it tells you what all documents you need to collect. And as you can see, it collects your academic history. So you will have to submit your official or unofficial transcripts that you have obtained from your undergraduate college. Submit TOEFL or IELTS scores unless you have pursued a degree here in the US already. You will have to submit an essay to prove what has prepared you for this program. Any background that you may have, whether you have done some projects in your undergraduate college, which will talk about your interest in the field, which is computer science. And then of course, as every graduate or even undergraduate college asks you for, you need a statement of purpose or SOP, which will talk about your academic and career plans and how this degree will help you to be successful with whatever you are doing. Alongside this, you also need 3 letters of recommendation or LORs as they call it. And they have suggested that you should probably get it from your current or former teachers, supervisors, who can actually talk about your intellectual ability, knowledge of your chosen field, and communication skills. So any information that you are looking for related to the OMS-CS program, you will find all that information on their website. The website is very comprehensive in terms of the details it captures. For example, if you were to check what current courses are being offered by the program, you can just go to their current courses section and you will find a list of all the courses that are being offered currently. If let's say I want to just look at one course and see what the syllabus is so that I can understand if it will be beneficial for me to actually offer this course. If I was interested in a course called Machine Learning for Trading CS7646 and I will see who the instructors are of this course, and there's a small preview video available as well for you to check out. At the same time, Georgia Tech does a really good job with posting their sample syllabus and the schedule of the course. So you can get a feeling of what is going to be covered in the course and then how much effort you will have to put with respect to the schedule of the course. So this is an example of what the summer semester is going to cover for this particular course. You can actually click on these links and find out what the projects are going to entail. You can read through the project material and understand if this is really something that you want to do. Most of the courses that are listed here have these details available when you go to the course page. Also, every course pretty much has this before taking this class section to check if you have the background and prerequisites which will help you be successful in the course. Understand that the goal of OMS-CS program is to help you be as successful as possible in this program and not withdraw from the program by just getting scared. So they just make sure that you understand what the courses really require and make your decisions based on your assessment. The other thing that I talked about in the previous video was about specializations. So I'm currently looking at their specializations section on the website. And as you can see, there are 4 specializations that are being offered right now. It will tell you what courses are considered considered to be core courses for that specialization and which ones are electives that you can choose from. You can find all that information here and decide on your specialization based on the courses that you would like to pursue. Now, no one is really stopping you from changing your specialization, although you have to declare the specialization that you will be opting for at the beginning of the semester. But if midway you decide for some reason that you would want to jump onto a different specialization, no one will stop you from doing that. As long as you are paying the fee for the course and registering for the proper courses that are going to meet the requirements of the specialization, no one is going to stop you from doing so. I also got another question around visa for this program. The website clearly mentions that they won't sponsor your visa because it's an online course, so you do not really have to be physically present in the US. If you are eligible to be present in the US through whatever visa you have, you do not have to worry about F1 visa. You can hop onto this program without worrying about your visa status. Now, there could be a question, what if tomorrow I want to switch from the online version of the program to the offline version or the on-campus version? That is possible, but you have to complete a few requirements before you can apply for that transfer, and it is a review process. If they have capacity on campus to accommodate a new student, they will approve it, but only if you have completed certain credits and you have met the requirements of the program till that point. Remember that as soon as you do the transfer to an on campus, you will definitely get the visa support that you want, but at the same time, you will now start paying the on-campus tuition fee, which will be way higher compared to what you're going to pay if you were to continue with the online program. Let's talk about scenario two. Let's say you are a working professional, doesn't matter where you are, and you are constantly thinking, I want to opt for this program, but I do not understand if I'll get the time to actually work on anything. Will I really have the capacity to work on the assignments which are to be submitted weekly, on the projects for the course, if I'm working 40 hours or more in a week? So first of all, there's a really good resource which is crowdsourced by the students of this program, which will help you assess how much time you really need for any course that you are opting for. Let's go and check it out. I just searched for OMS Central on Google. So OMS Central does a great job of helping you with assessing what your workload is going to be for a semester. You can choose the specialization that you're opting for, and only those courses will show up with their ratings as provided by the students, and you can also read student reviews on how they found the course to be. So for example, in the machine learning specialization, there's a course called Introduction to Graduate Algorithms. It has received 251 reviews and the difficulty level is 4.22 out of 5. The workload is 19.5 hours per week and the rating is 3.87. you will be able to read reviews from students who have taken this course, but you can also see that in some cases, students end up spending 30 hours per week, that too just for one course. So you can now start to see what courses will make sense based on what your bandwidth looks like when you are a working professional. OMS Central is definitely a really good resource for anyone who wants to understand what the workload is going to be like. And I have used this extensively to plan on what I should be opting for in a particular semester. Outside of that, there's a really great article that I read before I started with the program titled A Working Professional's Guide to the 7K CS Master's Degree. Now, this was posted in 2017, but all the facts listed in this article hold true even today. So anyone who asks me about the review for this program, I usually ask them to refer to this article because it has some great information on how hard are the classes, can you really do OMS CS and work or have a family at the same time, why is the degree so cheap. I'd like to call out a section that's particularly interesting in this article, and it's around only apply to this program if the following things about you are true. I'll not really read through all these points because I'll leave a link to this article in the description box below for you to read. If you are a working professional, this is definitely a great review that helps you get an idea of what this program is going to look like. I hope this information was helpful, and please let me know in the comment section
If you have any further questions about the program, and if you would like me to do a live session on this so that you can ask me these questions one-on-one. I'm also trying to get in touch with someone who has completed the program and they were not in the US and how it has impacted their career. I feel that it will be really powerful for someone to know that detail if they are planning to pursue a degree in CS online from Georgia Tech. If you like the content, do hit the like button, subscribe to the channel, do all the fancy stuff that they ask you to do. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you so much for watching.